Daniel here to talk SpectraLayers. With version 12 now available, I want to see whether the upgrade from 11 is worth it. The first change is the file size of version 12, which has jumped to 4 GB from 1 GB in version 11, possibly due to the additional AI models among other things. The most interesting changes stem from the new and improved modules, starting with Unmix Song. Before I test, if you're using a Windows operating system, SpectraLayers supports graphic card accelerated processing for unmixing audio, which you can check by going to Edit, Preferences, System, within Miscellaneous, the AI processing device, which by default and new in SpectraLayers 12, the auto setting, which has detected my NVIDIA RTX 470 Ti Super graphics card. I timed the unmixing speed with a 16 second snippet of an Afro R&B song using the CPU and GPU respectively for both versions, with the following settings on screen. Note that the unmix module in version 12 now shows the colors of the future unmix layers before unmixing, which is nice. The following times show that version 11 is faster at unmixing using the GPU, but slower at unmixing with the CPU. Unmix Song uses 4 AI models simultaneously, but 2 of them are not currently GPU accelerated. This will be enabled in a future patch, so I would expect the processing time for version 12 to improve. Let's hear the results of each layer side by side, starting with the full snippet of Aladdin by Femi J. For this particular track, the vocals in version 12 have improved slightly, with more high frequency content retained. The drums in version 12 also do a better job in preserving the kick drum, and there is better separation in the bass layer and guitar layer in version 12. So yes, the stems in version 12 are sounding better, but there's always room for improvement. Steinberg have stated that the quality of the Unmix transcription module has doubled, so let's test using the original vocals of the song snippet. Quality set to best in version 11 is the same as quality set to high in version 12. So let's apply and play it back while looking at the lyrics. Come take a trip with a boy Aladdin. Flying carpet, second nature. Come take a trip with a Aladdin. So version 12 is slightly better. Come take a trip with a boy in Latin is not correct. Neither is come take a trip with a boy and Laden. The correct lyrics is come take a trip with the boy Aladdin. Flying cop is second nature. Not quite, but version 12 does say it correctly. The Aladdin part, which has got a radio effect, isn't captured in either, but version 12 is slightly better. The new DePlosive module attenuates speech plosive sound, so let's give it a go with a vocal stem, same artist, but a different song. Shady in a backseat bad. The B's are plosive. So let's go to the DePlosive module. Let's use the defaults and just apply. You notice the bottom layer has removed. Let's play it back. Shady in a backseat bad. Before. Shady in a backseat bad. Shady in a backseat bad. So yeah, it does a decent job. One could also achieve this using the eraser tool, which I was doing in the past, but this will help. The voice enhance module uses generative AI to reconstruct poor quality voice recordings, particularly those that are frequency limited with clipping and noise. So I've got an example I've made. Let's have a listen. This is a voice recording from a phone. Let's go to the voice enhance module, use the default and hit apply.
This is a voice recording from
a phone. And before.
This is a voice recording from a phone. This is a voice recording from
a
phone.
So it does get rid of the noise. It does add higher frequencies. It sort of alters the tonality of my voice in a way that doesn't sound natural, but as a first pass, it's not bad, but we'll move on. Steinberg also mentioned that the Unmix Noisy Speech module has significantly improved. So let's test using another short but noisy clip. This is a voice recording with a fan in the background. So I'll apply on both versions and play it back.
This is a voice recording with a fan in the background. This is a voice recording with a fan in the background.
I'm not entirely convinced that version 12 is significantly better. Visually speaking, it does appear that more of the high end is being cut off at around 13 kilohertz, and that's not happening in version 11. So at least for this simple example, version 11 is superior. The voice denoiser has also been updated, but is effectively the same module as Unmix Noisy Speech, just without the noise layer, which I'll prove in SpectraLayers 12. So I'll delete the last action, duplicate the original layer, apply voice denoise on the duplicate layer. I'll keep the reduction ratio at 100, keep background to noise, hit apply. I'll close that. I'll apply Unmix Noisy Speech on the original layer. Hit apply. I will mute the noise layer. Close that. And I will just phase invert the duplicate layer and it nulls. So if I play back, there's nothing. Play that again.
This is a voice recording with a fan in the background.
Basically, it's identical. So the question remains if this upgrade is worth it. For the majority of my use cases, yes, but there's a few things that need to be refined. I also have a Google Sheet that provides a summary of over 70 features across SpectraLayers 12 and RX 11. I hope this comparison has been helpful. Take care and God bless.